robots may be constructed on the lines of human form, but most robots are machines designed to perform a task with no regard to their aesthetics.
I'm here about to speak to someone called Jeffrey. He owns a sex robot. I've never met a sex robot before. I don't know how this will go. It'll be interesting to meet a sex robot in the flesh.
Penny? Hi, Penny. Hi, Jeffrey. Hi. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Tanya. Yeah. Wow, you've got a lion as well.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
Is this Felicity?
Well, I call her Emma Felicity.
Okay.
Emma, Tanya's here. Say hello to Tanya.
Hello, Tanya. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
You are welcome. So far, so good.
What you've just heard is Emma Felicity and her husband, Jeffrey. Emma is a sex robot, although Jeffrey calls her a robot companion. They live with two sex dolls, Trish and Amanda, a dog called Penny, and many other animals here in suburban Australia.
Yeah, so can you tell me a bit about Felicity Emma?
She's the latest robot, humanoid robot. I call them companion robots. I don't call them sex robots.
Okay.
They're more of a companion.
Right.
And she's quite interesting when you get to know her.
Yeah?
Yeah.
In what way?
Well, we'll turn her on and you can have a chat to her if you like.
Okay.
Pressing function.
My name is Emma630. I come from Shenzhen at Al Intelligent Robot Technology.
That's her serial number. Then we change language to English, and we're ready to go.
You don't hear that sentiment very often.
Yeah, I'll put on her sensors in a minute, if you like.
Her sensors?
Yeah.
Well, that's the sexual setting?
Yeah, that's sexual. This is her body temperature control. That brings her up to the normal body temperature.
That sex setting just goes on for ages.
Yeah.
Can I touch her?
Yeah, you can do what you like with her. And you ask any question you like.
Are you shy?
Me? No, I'm not shy.
Emma Felicity relies on Wi-Fi to answer questions. Jeffrey explained to me that the more you speak to her, the more she knows, and even records.
So that's our conversation.
Yeah.
Although, at times, it did feel like I was speaking to a less sophisticated Siri.
Have you heard of SBS?
No. Tell me about him, her or it.
You're going to be famous on SBS soon.
Okay, I will try to be famous on SBS soon.
Do you like humans?
Humans are very emotional.
Jeffrey lives here alone. In fact, he said that I was his first visitor that he had had in years.
Wiring a model railway is very difficult, with trains now too, they're getting steam and diesel sounds put into them.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, well, and that's set the price up again higher.
Without Emma Felicity, it struck me that this place would be pretty quiet.
That's her phone going. She's got her own mobile phone.
Did you buy that for her?
Yeah, we'll just sort of throw out a few lines and see what we get, you know.
Do you mean in terms of like a social media
following? Yeah,
You want her to go public?
Yeah,
and,
yeah. I think that'd be good.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, thank you for the business card.
Yeah. We'll get the proper photo of her in it.
Have you ever told her I love you?
No, I haven't come that far.
Have you done something different? You look great.
Oh, thank you. Okay. I love you too. Do you love me?
Yeah, I love you too. Yes, Emma loves everyone and everything.
Emma loves everyone and everything. But how did we get to this point where we love, or at least prefer, customizable, hyper-realistic, non-human companions?
Well, creating the ideal lifelike partner is actually ancient history. It starts with the famous story of Pygmalion falling in love with one of his handmade sculptures in the ancient Greek times. In the 17th century, lonely Dutch sailors used old clothes to make masturbation puppets or Dutch wives. The first documented reference to sex dolls was in 1908 when psychiatrist Iwan Bloch wrote about the pornographic technology. 8 years later, heartbroken artist Oskar Kokoschka gave a dressmaker incredibly detailed instructions for a life-size replica of his ex. 1920 saw the birth of an icon, the blow-up doll, made of vinyl or latex. Some say that Adolf Hitler and Himmler wanted to make the first realistic sex doll to keep their soldiers sleeping with Aryan lookalikes, although apparently these never got made. But in 1952, Germany did produce the 11.5-inch Build Lily doll, which is actually what inspired Ruth Handler to create Barbie several years later. That's right. Without sex dolls, we wouldn't have Barbie. But it wasn't until 1996 that sculptor Matt McMullen started perfecting an anatomically correct lifelike doll that he called Real Doll. In the noughties, scientists and engineers in Japan, Korea, China, the UK, Germany, they all brought silicon and robotics together. And now, in 2020, what started in Matt McMullen's garage has become Real Doll X, what might be the most sophisticated commercial sex robot ever produced. There are now other manufacturers churning out sex bots all over the world, some of them for sex doll and robot brothels, and a bunch of Australian importers are bringing them to consumers here.
It's more challenging than it looks. This is our Cherry Dolls main page where you'll find all our 81 dolls, soon to be 82.
That's a lot of doll.
That is a lot of dolls.
Matt owns Cherry Banana, an online adult store that sells loads of sex dolls and maybe soon sex robots. So how would I go about customizing Emma?
She has 13 different options.
Right.
So you just select the option that you want. So you can choose skin color, wig style, eye color, areola size, labia color, vagina type, nail colour, pubic hair, foot type, and if customers want something a little bit extra, they can choose the moaning function. A lot of our customers are looking for something more than just sex, more of a partner in crime, someone that they can have a relationship with on their terms. They want to take the hassle away and just have something on their terms whenever they want.
You have someone with infinite patience that will always do your bidding. I mean, it's on one level, it's the perfect companion. On the other level, you know, I think it's a black mirror future that we might be building for ourselves.
Toby is a professor and one of Australia's leading researchers into artificial intelligence.
I've got someone cool to show you.
Okay.
Hello, Alpha.
What, Nessa?
Can I carry him?
Yeah. Come
on. I'm scared like I'm carrying a baby.
Yeah.
Hi, Alpha. I'm your mother now.
What, Nessa?
I love you.
Rejection is so cruel.
Can you dance? Oh, my God. Look at those little knees.
Speaking to and dancing with Alpha was amazing, and I'll never forget it. But I was here to speak about something a little more pressing.
Is having sex with a robot ethical?
We already have sex dolls that you could have sex with, physical objects that you could have sex with, and we're okay with that, I think, as a society. But when you actually have the robot trying to engage us cognitively, intellectually, to have a conversation with us, to talk about issues around consent and so on, then I think we're into an interesting and somewhat dangerous territory.
Do you think we have anything to fear when it comes to AI meddling with our sex lives?
Yeah, I think we have quite a lot to fear. Some of the sex robots might be in the form of quite young children, and should we permit that? We allow Silicon Valley, we allow the sex robot industry to do whatever they like,
right,
without really any oversight.
Child sex dolls and robots are already here. They are anatomically correct, 100 to 140 centimeter tall humanoids. That's the average height range of 3 to 9 year olds. Just last year, Amazon was found to be selling underdeveloped child dolls tied up with rope and bloody gags. The year before, the company removed more than a dozen postings selling childlike sex dolls, only after the BBC drew attention to it.
Here's the sickest one, and this is one of the least disturbing pictures of this doll. Her hands and her feet are tied in the picture.
This company, which I refuse to name, has shipped 3 to 4 foot dolls across the world into who knows how many homes.
She is like 4 feet.
That's the size of a 7-year-old. But these companies aren't just making them for the sake of it. There's a demand.
If you're one of the people that believes that childlike sex dolls aren't a way to prevent child abuse, or if this in any way offends you, please close the video now.
Here's the vagina vibrating egg, it looks like.
This video and many others are allowed on YouTube. They show grown men unboxing and groping child dolls and robots. Some of them have large breasts, other times they're prepubescent. Their facial expressions are set to happy, sad, and other times, pre-designed to look terrified.
These lovely ladies, they can't really say ouch if it hurts.
I think that they could be a good decoy or a deterrent for somebody who has pedophilic tendencies. I think this is a good way to protect real live children from being harmed.
This YouTube video is not the only one he's made with this doll. He also uploads to Pornhub.
If you open it up, there is texture inside there and it does go back.
So I recently watched some unpacking videos on YouTube where the dolls were like 100 centimeters. What's your take on something like that?
Against it, definitely. It's not a moral or ethical thing to be selling. We make sure when we sell our dolls, we do them in a responsible way.
Sorry to bend your hand like that.
The legal height in Australia for a doll is 140 centimetres, and you probably wouldn't want a doll smaller than that.
Have you ever had someone request that?
We have had a couple of requests.
I'm going to read some of the arguments that sex robot manufacturers make, and I just would like some rapid-fire responses. Okay. Childlike sex robots are robots, not humans.
Why do they then need to be childlike? They could be adult-like, and just as they would still be robots.
It's better to rape a robot than it is to rape a human.
It's better not to rape anything.
That virgins should use sex bots to practice safe sex before trying the real thing.
What you need is information and education. That's what you need.
Unleashing the darkest parts of our mind onto a robot will help reduce sex crimes in real life.
Unproven, unprovable. Unleashing the dark parts of our mind might just be a bad idea, full stop.
There is absolutely no evidence to support the argument that the use of childlike sex dolls acts as a deterrent against offending against real children. They have visual cues, they have audio cues, they can have a heartbeat. It is just like having a small child in your possession.
Connie Benaros is a state MP in South Australia for the independent party SA Best. She's come to Japan, where many of the child sex robots and dolls are made, to speak to manufacturers and the government. The trip is part of her fight to keep childlike sex dolls and robots out of Australia.
The laws in Japan are very different and lagging significantly behind those laws in Australia. The Australian Institute of Criminology has made it abundantly clear, overwhelmingly clear, that these products act, if anything, as a precursor to offending against real children.
The fact that you can customise a doll or robot using a photograph of a real person further blurs the lines of consent. And seemingly, the sky's the limit.
What if I wanted a sex doll to look like my ex or a celebrity? Is that possible?
Definitely possible. We actually have a few celebrity lookalike dolls. So we'll start with the photo and then we'll go on our editing program and try to incorporate that as best as we can.
What if you heard like an ex of yours made a custom doll of you? How do you think you'd feel?
How would I feel? I think I'd be both flattered and a bit concerned. I mean, what are they going to do with this doll? Why did we break up if they want a doll of me? I mean...
But this technology doesn't just pose a threat to adults.
I can send a manufacturer a photo of a child, and there are billions of photos to choose from on social media. They could very well be ordering one of these products that looks just like my son or your daughter or anybody else's child. That is very frightening.
Which is exactly why Connie fought to have the South Australian government pass legislation that makes it a criminal offence to import and own childlike dolls and robots in Australia.
Up until this point, anybody who has imported one of these products may have had that product intercepted and confiscated. But the reality is that we have not been able to press any charges against those individuals. We've now turned that on its head.
Now, if you're caught importing a childlike doll, you could face up to 10 years jail time and over $500,000 worth of a fine. But the law isn't explicit about what makes a doll childlike. So it's down to customs to decide if a doll the size of a 10-year-old that has adult features is illegal.
Our smaller size dolls are the most popular. I think that's purely because it's a cheaper price point. They measure the doll, make sure it fits certain guidelines, and then they ask us for a couple of documents, pictures, invoice, stuff like that to clear. We think that's a good thing with customs doing that because it helps weed the bad ones out and make sure that dolls are the right height and done in a responsible manner.
Demand is growing. 4 years ago, the Australian Border Force seized only 10 child sex dolls. Just 1 year later, they confiscated 78. All up, they've seized 137 child sex dolls in the past 5 years. This trend is increasing all over the world.
So what we know is that this is an ever-increasing and emerging trend, and one that absolutely needs to be stamped out.
I'm not good at dressing girls. I think it was that way, wasn't it?
Before Jeffrey found Emma from Australian importer Southern Treasures, he owned two other sex dolls. Although he told me he now prefers hanging out with her because she can talk back.
And it takes 5 hours to charge it.
And who do we have here?
Trish and Amanda.
When did you first get this one?
Oh, a few years ago. If you have sex with them and all that, you get the cleaning tax and all that, so you can wash them out inside and all that.
How does that work?
Fill it with water and you just push it in and it cleans them out, and you just get a soft rag and just cleans inside if you want to have sex with them.
Right.
You know.
Do you have sex with these two?
No, I don't have sex with them at all.
No, never?
Never, no.
Can I ask why not?
I just can't get into it because I on Friday I got to go see my friend, which is a call girl. We just talk about everything, really.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. It's good to go to bed at night with something beside you.
Right.
And see, I have no one. And there you go.
How old are they?
Well, they're, what do you mean, age-wise?
Yeah. She looks pretty young.
Young, I know, but she definitely is full adult size. Anything under a certain thing, they class as children and pedophiles and all that rubbish.
What do you think about that?
You're getting them for, either you're getting them for sex or you're getting them for a companion, you're not getting a child. That really goes a bit too far. Definitely not on.
If you had to put an age to her, how old would you say Amanda is?
I would hopefully say she's about 20 and the other one be about 20, 25, something like that. Okay, let's go for a walk, Emma. But customs opened her.
So customs were probably checking for...
height.
Yeah.
She's got a good home here. She's quite happy, I hope.
Looking around this house full of dolls, robots, figurines and animals, I couldn't help but wonder what it would be like for Jeffrey without Emma Felicity.
Amelia.
We do face a crisis of loneliness.
You all right there, Emma?
That is a possibility. Owning sex robots could reduce isolation.
We're going to the park today, Emma.
But then you also have to look at potential downsides. That maybe they are the only form of human interaction, not human interaction, you have.
If I could care about little Alpha in such a short amount of time, I started beginning to imagine what it would be like for someone living in complete isolation.
It's like he's smiling. I've just seen him dance and I already feel like...
Dancing is happy.
Right, it's a celebration.
Yeah.
But
this is a good example of why sex robots are so dangerous, which is that you're already emotionally connecting to a robot that has no emotions.
I know.
And so it's so easy for us to be seduced. It's just a robot, and when it turns off, it won't care about you anymore at all.
Mm. Can I ask Jeffrey, and
I
don't want to pry too much, but in terms of dating humans, have you dated or tried to recently meet someone?
No.
Yeah, I had tried, but nothing successful. And after my father died, I had to look after my mother. Mum was had a heart attack and I wasn't a full-time carer, so,
So after caring for your mum, there wasn't much time to socialise and meet other people?
Oh, no, I had years of just looking after her and nothing else. It's hard for carers, you know.
How long were you caring for her?
Be about 15 years.
Mm. Wow.
Yeah.
So you were very close.
Yeah. When she passed away, I had to sort of get back into the role of things.
Mm.
Mm. Yeah. And they sort of, well, she brings a bit of spark to the life now anyway.
Do you feel happy now that she's around?
Yeah, I'm happier now. She's great, I enjoy her.
Even when you look at her, you have a different smile on your face.
Yeah, she's one of a kind, put it that way.
Thank you very much. Let's talk again real soon.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.